So if you have an iPhone and you're not using iCloud Drive for much, there is probably one feature of iCloud Drive you're using and you're probably not even thinking about it. You're using iCloud Backup. iCloud Backup allows you to have your iPhone backed up to iCloud and using that 5 GB of free storage space that you get with iCloud. Now this backup is really important because if you lose your iPhone or it breaks or something, then you can restore to a new iPhone. A lot of people don't even know that this is happening and they're pleasantly surprised when they go to the Apple Store and get a new iPhone and the tech there is able to restore all their stuff. It wasn't that many years ago that if you lost your iPhone and got a new one, you were dismayed to find out you lost a lot of things. So iCloud Backup is great, but it's not so great if you find you're going over the 5 GB limit because your iCloud Backup is too big. But you can fix that because you can decide what gets backed up and what doesn't. But it's really hidden. Now on your iPhone, if you go into Settings and then you tap on your Apple ID at the top. So it's got your name, it says Apple ID, Cloud, iTunes, etc. You go into there, then you can see information about your Apple ID including iCloud. So we'll go into iCloud here, and then if we scroll down we can see iCloud Backup. We go into that and you can see it should be turned on. Everybody should be using iCloud Backup. There's really no excuse not to back up. It's so important. And you've got a Backup Now button, but you don't have any kind of way to customize what's going on there. So how do you customize what gets backed up? Well, it's not here. It's at the top again. You go to Manage Storage. And if you look at Manage Storage, you can see it says Backups. And this is your iCloud storage here. So you can see I have the 5 GB free plan. I'm using a lot of that for photos. And Backups is my next biggest thing. So I go into Backups. It's going to take me into there and it's going to show me, okay, it's backing up documents and data, almost 1 GB worth. And I actually have it divided between an iPad and an iPhone on this account. So it's only half, or a little less than half, this iPhone. If I tap on this iPhone, I go in there, it's going to say, okay, last backup. That's always good to check to know it's all working. The size of the backup, the next backup size. In other words, you know, I've added things, I've changed things, so what's it going to add to the backup next time? And then I see this great list of apps and whether or not they're backing up and how much space they're using. So this is key here because you could really shrink the size of your backup by turning things off. Now, something you don't want to turn off, right? It's backing up, which is great, and you want to save all that stuff. But some stuff you don't really care about. Like for instance, Audible, you know, I can always re-download those books and I know it's syncing to Amazon's service there for saving my settings and things. And there's some other things in here, maybe just apps I've experimented with. I don't really care about the data, or I know the data is being saved some other way. And I could just turn those off and save that space. So it's something you may want to look at. So I talk about this and every other aspect of iCloud in my new course, The Guide to iCloud. This is a comprehensive course with 3+ hours of videos all about all the different ways you can use iCloud, how to use it, where to access all the features. You can read more about it, and if you're watching this video just after it came out, there's a special introductory price that you can get for the course as well. Thank you.